Now, buying island food in Auckland's pretty common when you have whaleanga like Le Sunrise or Pingakis, but the further south you go, finding pangikeke can be tough. That's why two enterprising women in Christchurch decided to open a new food outlet specialising in our cuisine. Tangalo Tele o Sone Okesene headed to the Garden City for a taste.
It's the best thing to come out of Aranui since, well, shrimp.
Oh, I love the orca because it's just divine.
Except you won't get an earful.
The vegetables are beautiful and the coconut cream is just, yeah, it's like getting it back home.
More like a tummy full.
It's good, it's convenient. You can come and grab it and just leave.
I think it's doing a lot for Aranui. Yes, and the food is lovely. It's really good quality.
The business is the brainchild of two women who wanted to put more Pacific flavour into the Garden City.
What inspired me was seeing my parents get up early every morning on a Sunday doing what we call kukmai, which is Sunday lunch, and seeing them get up so early in the morning doing it, and I just thought, why not just go and buy it like how we go and buy KFC?
Deborah's cousin Rebecca thought it was a great idea and became a partner.
Deborah and I are first generation New Zealand-born Samoans. We can't cook it ourselves, and the only time that we get it is when we go home. So we thought, how many other New Zealand-born young people are in the same shoes that we're in?
And then there's that name, taken from a T-shirt after a visit to the Otara Flea Market in Auckland.
Lots of laughing coming through the door. We haven't had really anybody that's said, what's Fobby?
Already we've got nicknames for Dr. Fobbys. It's either go down to Fobbys or go down to Docs. So yeah, it's been really good, really well received by everybody.
The name sorted, time to set the menu. It's one thing having the traditional fare, but how to give it that extra flair.
Dr. Fobby's prescriptions are basically our specialty foods, and it was just something that I was sitting in front of the computer just trying to Google the medical terms, and that was sort of one of the more low-key ones, the prescriptions that I could spell as well. Yeah, our traditional taro and green banana, as well as the raw fish dish, all our baking that we've grown up with, like bunny popo, sweet coconut buns, bulingi, the sweet nutmeg cake, as well as bangkikis is our sort of famous food at the moment, and flounders, the pig heads also is another real goer.
And so far, the food's catching on.
First time I saw the flounders, so that's my favourite too, so I might have one now.
There's even something for the health conscious.
So that's why I love the orca, because it's the healthiest out of the lot, I think. Yeah, but you have to have your treats as well. Yeah, I love the pancakes, so yeah, as long as it's all in moderation, I guess.
We tweak some of the recipes just so it's a bit more fat friendly, but yeah.
As for the new business owners, Dr. Fobby so far has been a dream come true.
It's been an exciting adventure because it's new.
You call the shots, you're the one that makes up the rules, and you're in control of everything, so how well your business goes is basically how much effort you put into it. So that's what really excites me, and just the challenge of it just challenges me on sort of all levels, mentally and physically as well.
Keep trimming those edges to make your food more healthy.